Alright, so I'm going to do a combination thing that now has to do with a horizontal shift. Horizontal shifts, be very careful. You might see, this was our vertical shift. This will be our horizontal shift, and this is our amplitude, and this is our cycles per 2 pi. I'll just erase that for now. Okay, so negative sign, looks like we're going to move left. Well, guess what? That's not how to interpret that. So don't make that mistake. Basically, it rolls like this. Anytime we have this kind of setup, you'll see in the other transformation units and everything, we take this section, we're going to find out what our horizontal shift is. We set it to zero. Okay? Just like finding the roots in quadratic equations, right? The roots are where things cross, or the solutions. We always have to set something equal to zero. You always set something equal to zero. I'm just drawing for the fun of it. So let's go look at this here. Theta minus 3/2 pi equals zero. I want to get theta by itself here, because it's the variable. So I'll add 3/2 pi to both sides. Okay, well, ta-da, guess what? That's a positive sign. Therefore, we move positive direction. Okay, we are at the final conclusion. Therefore, this moves right, because right is positive. Okay. How far are we going to move this graph right? We're going to move it to the right 3/2 pi. Okay. Let's, ignoring this stuff, and well, that's one, so that's a piece of cake. And ignoring that, let's look at this here. Did I spit on the board here? If we had this, okay, this would be pi, this would be 3/2 pi, and this would be 4/2 pi, or 2 pi. And this would be pi halves, or 1/2 pi. Okay? So what we're saying is we're going to move this whole graph 3/2 pi. So the starting point of here, this graph, as zero, now the starting point becomes here. Every single point gets moved to reflect this. So what this graph, it has a shift to the right of this many units. Okay? Now, because this graph goes on and on forever in both directions, we might also be able to realize that at 3/2 pi, she's gonna look like this eventually. But all you really need to pay attention to at this stage is that you're moving this starting point, every point on our graph, zip, 3/2 to the right. Okay, so here's our starting point right here. Okay. I will just deal with that section of the graph, and let's look at the rest of this here. So our starting is at 3/2 here. We have a vertical shift, right, and an amplitude of 3. So instead of saying our boundaries are positive 3 and negative 3, our boundaries are actually negative 2 and positive 4 because of the vertical shift. Okay, so that's the first thing that we're going to just clear up there. That's good. There's no reflection. Don't worry about a reflection. Okay, so there's our boundaries. Our amplitude is 3. That's taken care of. And our starting point, instead of being at right here, our starting point is at 3/2 pi. So what our graph really is going to look like from here. There's a middle point. It's going to look like this. And because this is one whole cycle over 2 pi, that means that this would be, if that's 1/2 pi, this would be, okay, whoa, hang on a second. 3/2 plus 4/2, that's 7/2, okay. So this endpoint here would be 7/2 pi, whatever that turns out to be, okay. So this would be our resulting graph. We've shifted it up. Our amplitude is not 1, it's 3. And we have shifted it horizontally. Okay? The key is setting to zero, right? Don't let that fool you to think you have to move it left. Okay? Biggest mistake people make. Any questions? Give me a holler.